Joining me now is my friend Kellyanne Conway, who is not only a Jersey girl, but she is the one that broke the glass ceiling in presidential politics, becoming the first woman to successfully manage a presidential campaign. Boy, you'd think that the media would give her credit and accolades, but no, because it's all about Trump, and it's always negative when it comes to the media, and that's a shame. But I'll tell you something, Kellyanne has been standing strong for this administration since day one, and she joins me now. Good morning, Kellyanne. How are you?
Bill, it's great to be with you, an old and trusted friend, and not old, you know what I mean.
I got it.
A long way, my dear, and what an exciting, just exhilarating day to have President Trump going into South Jersey. South Jersey is Trump country.
Yeah.
I learned this morning from the campaign that they broke an all-time rally ticket request record in Wildwood, New Jersey, of all places. Over 175,000 ticket requests for a venue that holds about 8,000 people.
Yeah.
So it's pretty exciting. The media will always say, yes, Kelly, and we see all these people, but will they vote? No, they laid outside in tents for 2 days just to be where he is, to be part of a movement, but we're not sure they'll vote. We
right.
know they'll vote, Bill.
Of course they will.
And there are lots of hidden undercover Trump voters as well who love the progress report, who love the fact that we have major tax cut and jobs overhaul. We have job security, mobility, including there in New Jersey, despite many liberal left-of-center policies by the governor and the Democratic state legislature. This Trump economy has helped New Jersey get back to work. And even beyond that, we have two dead terrorists, two Supreme Court justices, two new trade deals. I think that equals two terms, and I'm going to say it tonight.
Wow. You know what? That is a great line, Kellyanne. And you know what? It's true. And I will tell you, you know, you're a Jersey girl. It feels like in the last few years, we've been behind enemy lines in this state. You've got an attorney general that is pushing a sanctuary state policy that is literally threatening the lives of law enforcement and endangering our communities. You've got a governor who's doing nothing but fighting against every single thing that the Trump administration is doing. Despite that, and thankfully, you and the president have shown the kind of courage in the face of so many institutional enemies, but you're breaking them down one by one. And you know, you've given really a voice to the people in New Jersey who have been told for years now they don't have a voice. You can't support Trump in a place like New Jersey. You proved today it's just not true.
It's true. And when President Trump was running for office, Bill, he famously said that he was running as the first non-military, non-elective government official ever in our nation's history to succeed. He was running for the forgotten man or forgotten woman, and they feel forgotten no more. And even the forgotten child, these kids who are languishing in underperforming schools where they're trapped just because of their zip code, we're against that. We believe in school choice and charter schools and education freedom scholarships. We believe in prosperity, and we also, and this is a big shout out to my native South Jersey, I love the fact that in the Trump economy, the wage growth has boosted everybody up and down the wage chain, and that so much of the economic prosperity is known credibly as a blue-collar boom. The farmers, the ranchers, the manufacturers, the auto workers, including in South Jersey, the farmers, they get a net plus from these major two trade deals now, one with Mexico and China, Mexico and Canada, excuse me, and the other with China. That's a big boost to the economy, but forgotten no more, because I can tell you, people feel for years, Bill, especially in New Jersey, if you are, you know, a conservative or you're a Republican or you're just somebody who wants to be left alone, wants a federal government that's intrusive, invasive, expensive, expansive, you have in Donald Trump an ally. People feel like they're pressing their nose up against the glass looking in. I think in Donald Trump, the outsiders finally got their insider, and he's there for them. Look what he's done for the military.
It's huge.
And our veterans.
And law enforcement.
They are better resourced and more deeply respected now because of President Trump.
You know, and union workers as well. Like all these traditional areas where you think that the Democrats would do well, I think they overreached on impeachment. And it's just a constant attacks every day. It's so counterproductive. But you and the president have stayed strong and shown courage in the face of this adversity. I want to thank you, and I'm really proud that you're a Jersey girl, and you've never forgotten your roots, Kellyanne.
Right back at you, Bill. Thanks. Keep up the fight.